So next is the types of inflorescence. So they are broadly divided into three types of the inflorescence: racemos, cymos, and special type of inflorescence. So cymos is also known as the indefinite, and cymos is known as the definite type of inflorescence. So racemos mein kya hota hai, the main axis is continuous to grow and flowers are born laterally, means like this is the main axis, okay, so it is going to be continuously grow and the flowers are born laterally, okay, and they are arranged in the agropetal manner. They are arranged in the agropetal manner. Agropetal means the base flower is the older one and the apex flower are the new one. Agropetal. A se remember kiya ki A means apex. Okay. So apex pe jo flower hoga wo new hoga aur jo base pe flower hoga wo kya hoga? Old hoga. Okay. So jo racemos type of inflorescence hai, ye further divide hota hai. Is further divided. So racemos are divided on three bases. Okay, main axis is elongated. Main axis shortened and main axis flattened. Okay. So main axis किस किस type of racemos में elongated होती है? First raceme, second compound raceme, which is also known as panicle, then spike, then spikelet. Spikelet is also known as compound spike. Then catkin, then spadix, then main axis shortened, corymb and umbel. Detail में जाए तो compound corymb भी होता है, compound umbel भी होता है. Main axis flattened, that is in capitulum. Or we can also say that racemos hai. Okay, so raceme we are going to study first. So what happened in the raceme? The main axis is going to be elongated and flowers are born laterally, and flowers kya hote hai isme? Pedicellated hote hai. Means flowers are having their own pedicel. So if I am going to draw this axis, so okay, so flowers are born laterally and they are pedicellated. 1, 2, 3, 4. So one wala older hua and fourth one is the younger one, or this is the agropetal fashion. And the examples of these are reddish, mustard. Okay, in these type of the plants you can see the raceme type of the inflorescence. Okay, फिर second type आता है compound raceme, or we can say panicle. Compound raceme. इसमें क्या होता है, जो this is the elongated main branch and then they are having the branching now. Okay, laterally the branches are present and on branches pedicellated flowers are present. ओके, ब्रांच के ऊपर क्या प्रेजेंट हो रहा है? पेडिसिलेटेड फ्लावर. यहाँ पे डायरेक्टली मेन एक्सिस पे फ्लावर्स बॉर्न हो रहे थे, डेवलप हो रहे थे. यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है, मेन एक्सिस में भी ब्रांचिंग हो रही है, फिर ब्रांचिंग के ऊपर क्या प्रेजेंट हो रहे हैं, फ्लावर्स फॉर्म हो रहे हैं, दे आर ऑल्सो पेडिसिलेटेड. ओके, एग्जाम्पल गुलमोहर एंड knee. Okay, in these two, the flowers are what? Bisexual. Flowers are bisexual. The third type is spike. Okay, the third type is spike. So, in this spike, what? The main axis is elongated, but the flowers are sessile. Okay, this is the main axis and the flowers are sessile. We can have bract here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, main axis is elongated, but flowers are sessile in this case. Okay, example. Piper longum. Isko like long that is peepee in Hindi. Okay, and this is the spike. Then compound spike, next is the spikelet. So fourth one is the spikelet. It is also known as the compound raceme, or it is mainly found in the Gramineae family. Gramineae family ke examples are like wheat, oat, grass. Okay, in these they are going to be found. So ye thoda sa concentratedly sunna hai ki these are the wheat spike. Okay, ye wheat spike hai. और एक पार्टिकुलर यदि हम किसी को किसी एक स्पाइक को स्पाइकलेट को ओपन करके देखेंगे देयर आर मेनी स्ट्रक्चर्स आर प्रेजेंट. ओके, सो इट इज अ वीट स्पाइकलेट और हर एक स्पाइकलेट के अंदर एक इंडिविजुअल एक स्ट्रक्चर प्रेजेंट होता है. सो बेसिकली देयर मेन एक्सिस इज गोइंग टू बी ब्रांच, क्योंकि हमने किस में देखा था स्पाइक में द मेन एक्सिस इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी ब्रांच. तो कंपाउंड स्पाइक में क्या होगा, द मेन एक्सिस इज गोइंग टू बी ब्रांच्ड. And on the branching, the flowers are arranged in the manner of the spike. Other than the spike things also, there are some other structures, floral appendages are present in the case of the spikelet inflorescence. Okay, so main yahan pe main axis form kar rahi hu. Aur jo each spikelet hota hai, matlab jo ek spikelet hota hai, wo usme kya present hota hai? Two bracts present hote hain and one or more florets. Okay, so each spikelet has two bracts, or those bracts are known as glume. They are known as what? Glume. And other than the glume, they are also having one or more florets. Okay, fine. And these florets, and these florets are having what? Florets are having flower followed by two more bracts. Okay, followed by two or more bracts. हम उनको bracteoles बोलते हैं. Bracteoles, two bracteoles called lemma and palea. Two bracteoles के अलावा भी उनमें क्या present होता है, एक और चीज, tepal. Perianth is the रोल ऑफ दी टेपल. सेपल प्लस पेटल इज इक्वल्स टू टेपल. किन्नी किन्नी फ्लावर के अंदर ओनली वन अपेंडिज टाइप प्रेजेंट होता है, दैट इज नोन एज दी टेपल. ओके, सो हियर दे आर हैविंग दी टेपल विच इज नोन एज दी लॉडिक्यूल्स. ओके, एंड देन दे आर हैविंग दी थ्री स्टेमन एंड अ ओवरी विद टू स्टिग्मा. Okay, so I am going to draw here one spikelet. See, lower and the upper glume. This is the, these two are the glume. What is? They are the bracts. Okay, and I said each spikelet has two bracts and one or more florets. Okay, so hum ek spikelet form kar rahe hain. Isme two glume present hai, two bracts present hai. Fir Florets are present, and florets के अंदर क्या होता है, फ्लावर के साथ साथ क्या होते हैं, appendages, other appendages भी present होते हैं, like bracteoles, सो जो लेमा ब्रैक्टीरियल होता है दिस इज लेमा. जो लेमा होता है वो पेलिया से थोड़ा बड़ा होता है. ओके दीज आर द टू ब्रैक्टीरियल्स. देन दे आर हैविंग दी दीज आर द लॉडिक्यूल्स. लॉडिक्यूल्स आर व्हाट? टेपल. ओके एंड देन दे आर हैविंग दिस फ्लावर. So in flower you are seeing that ये तो gloom हो गया. तो फिर they are having lemma and palea, two bracteoles, then lodicule which is a tepal, and then they are having three stamen. These are stamen. और ये क्या है? ovary जिसके अंदर two stigma present है, feathery होते हैं ये. क्योंकि इनमें क्या होता है? What pollination they are having? Air pollination they are having. ओके सो ये फेदरी होते हैं, लाइट वेटेड होते हैं, तो ये एयर के थ्रू मूव कर जाते हैं. ओके सेम यहां पे भी आई कैन ड्रॉ हियर वन मोर फ्लोरेट. फाइन लाइक दिस. ओके दीज आर द टू लॉडिक्यूल्स, देन दिस इज द स्टेमन एंड हियर द फेदरी स्टिग्मा विद अ ओवेरी. ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट वन स्पाइकलेट. और एक स्पाइकलेट में टू ब्रैक्स होते हैं, देन दे आर हैविंग दी वन और मोर फ्लोरेट. और हर एक फ्लोरेट कैसे फॉर्म होता है? लेमा, पेलिया, लॉडिक्यूल्स एंड देन दी स्टेमन एंड व्हाट? फीमेल पार्ट. ओके फ्रॉम दिस लेमा अ थिन हेयरी स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्म दैट इज नोन एज दी ऑन. ओके हियर आई हैव ड्रॉन दिस ऑन. ओके ऑन हेल्प्स इन द फोटोसिंथेसिस in the seed dispersals also. Okay, so again I am repeating what spikelet has two bracts. Each spikelet has two bracts which is known as gloom, lower and the upper gloom, and each spikelet has one or more florets. Florets are having flower followed by two bracteoles, that is lemma and palea, and they are having then lodicules. Sepal petal nahi hota wahan pe, lodicules. A type of a tepal is present and they are having then three stamen and a ovary with a two stigma. Okay. So this is what the spikelet. Fine. Next we are going to study the fifth type of the inflorescence, that is catkin. Fifth type, catkin. Catkin is also having the sessile flower and their peduncle is elongated. Okay, but their inflorescence, the main axis is weak and thin, and they are having the unisexual flowers. In the spike, you are having the bisexual. Spikelet में भी हमने देखा कि they are having the what? Bisexual flowers. In the case of catkin, they are having what? Unisexual flowers. This is how they are different from the spike. Okay, and their main floral axis is thin and weak. So example here, mulberry. In the Hindi, shehtoot. Okay, so you can see here, this is the leaf and here they are having the catkin. Flowers are sessile. Okay, small. Next is the sixth one, is the spadix. Okay, in the spadix, the peduncle is the fleshy one. Okay, the peduncle is the fleshy one and the bract is going to be converted into the going to be folded, and they are green in color or colorful to attract what? Pollinators. Okay, so peduncle is fleshy here. Fine. this is the peduncle, and this is the bract, which is known as spathy. This is colorful. Okay, at the base of the peduncle, they are having the three types of the flower. Here, they are having the, I will just draw with this male flower, and at the base, they are having the, here they are having the male flower, at the base, they are having the female flower. And in between the female and male flower, they are having the sterile flower. Okay, so peduncle is fleshy and the bract is going to be covered it, and they are having the sterile flower in between the male flower and the female flower. Example here, banana, maize, colocasia. Okay, so these are the type of the what? Racemos, in which the main axis is elongated. Next we are going to study, the main axis is the shortened. Next type of the racemos in which we are going to study, where the main axis is shortened. So it's got two types hai, corymb and umb. Okay, इसमें क्या होता है, main axis shortened हो जाता है and the flowers are pedicellated. Okay, flowers are pedicellated, but see here, the flowers are pedicellated, but here is what, the lower flower is having the longer pedicel than the upper one, क्योंकि ये सब लोग एक ही axis में आ रहे हैं. All the flowers are having the same axis. They have to come on a same axis, so that क्या हो रहा है, जो lower flower का pedicel है वो बड़ा है in compared to the upper one. So that all the flowers are going to be seen in a same axis. Okay. So here the example are candida. Okay. इसका इसमें भी branching हो जाए. Which is known as compound raceme. Okay, like this. Okay, फिर compound raceme में main flowers नहीं terminate होगा branch में. फिर यहाँ पे again. Understanding? So all flowers are going to be seen in a one axis only. You can see the compound corymb example in the cauliflower. Full gobi जो we are consuming, that is the compound corymb only, the main axis is there, and then they are branches and they are terminated in the flowers, and all flowers are the in the main axis. Okay, corymb, umbel. Umbel, what is happening here, the all the flowers are going to be originate from the same point, like this. Okay, they are going to present on a main one point only. They are going to be arise from one point only, and they are having the bracts involucre of role of the bracts, which is known as the involucre. What is this? Role of bracts, that is known as the involucre. Okay, example of it is like your coriandrum, fennel, okay, cumin. Fine, these are the example of the umbel. Next to racemos type is the when the main axis is flattened. Where main axis is flattened. में है एग्जाम्पल, द टाइप इज रेसिमोस हेड, विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द कैपिटुलम. ओके, विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द कैपिटुलम. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, द पेडंकल बिकम द फ्लैटेंड वन, लाइक दिस. ओके, द पेडंकल बिकम फ्लैटेंड वन एंड दे आर हैविंग द सेसाइल फ्लावर्स. Okay, they are having the sessile flower. So this kind of a structure, they are going to form the disc florets. Okay, in some cases, all the flowers are same. So they are known as the homogamous head. Homogamous head. But in some case, other than the disc florets, they are also having a type 2, that is ray florets. If you have observed your sunflower, okay. This is the sunflower. Inside this, this is the disc floret, and this is ray florets. Okay, example is the sunflower. Fine. So disc floret and the ray floret, which is arises from the disc floret size, and disc floret is a bisexual and ray florets are the neutral one, or it might be then the female version also. It can be. So this is the racemos head. Okay, so we have discussed the raceme three bases, in which like main axis is elongated, shorter, and the flattened one. In elongated one, we have seen raceme, compound raceme, spike, spikelet, catkin, and the last one, catkin, and the last one is the spadix. Next, we have discussed the main axis is shortened, corymb, and the umbel, and the flattened one is the racemose head. In the next video, we are going to study the cymose. Thank you.